Welcome to the module CS3DP, Distributed and Parallel Computing. Today I will give a very broad introduction to the topic. My name is Julian Kunkel and I'm supported by Christopher Maynard. Let me first give you the learning outcomes of today's session. By today's session I mean really it's not only the lecture that I give, but I expect that you will check out the lecture material such that you will be ultimately able to answer this learning outcomes, right? So there will be additional material presented in every of the session that I give for the sole reason to give you a very broad overview of the topic. This topic is really huge, so 1 hour a week lecture isn't enough, right? But the learning outcomes are those things that are really the essential parts that you should keep that will be assessed. Okay. So you may be able to skip them and come back later after you watched the other videos of this session, but I will read them out now. So after the session, a participant should be able to recite system characteristics for distributed parallel and computational science, describe use cases and challenges in the domain of distributed parallel and scientific computing, sketch generic distributed and parallel system architectures, and finally, describe how the scientific method relies on distributed parallel and scientific computing. So then we have also the domain of big data. So you should be able to name the big data challenges and a typical workflow involved in big data workflows. So today's session covers those different topics. So we have distributed computing, parallel computing, computational science, and the topic of big data. And at the end, I will also give a quick introduction how this module is organized, but you will have that as well in the module roadmap.